signed up for the Army in 1978. I repair weapons. Anything that the military fired, I fixed. I got hired at the post office in 1983. I enjoyed being a letter carrier for 30 years, and I would have still been doing it if I didn't get blessed with this illness. I couldn't drive my vehicle no more. I couldn't walk. I had no movement in my shoulders. I couldn't perform my route. I'd get on the route and freeze up. That was very hard for me.
Miles is a 53-year-old man who has Parkinson's for the last 14 years. He has suffered until about a year ago with really bad motor fluctuations, severe rigidity, tremor, and where he did get to a point where he needed a wheelchair to go long distances, and also he had a lot of pain.
Parkinson's disease patients do have a lot of pain. We often don't stress that as the main symptom that we talk about with Parkinson's disease. We often are thinking about their motor problems, their tremor, their slowness, their gait, but pain can be a significant symptom as well.
Hi, Mr. Garcia.
Hello.
Dr. Officer, nice to see you again.
There's a lot of different ways in which pain can be a part of the syndrome. And one of the things that we often see it associated with is that of prominent rigidity.
The way a patient would sense rigidity is that they're very tight. It looks like you have tight muscles.
And dystonia is another type of movement that is associated with co-contraction of muscles.
For example, the neck will start activating on one side repetitively, consistently, without stopping. And you start to see maybe that same turn of the head if the neck muscles are dystonic.
There's more of an abnormal curling of a joint, of a foot, of a toe. It could curl down, it could curl up.
And it's often associated with pain.
Miles' worst pain was between his shoulder blades in the back. And it was really troubling to try to sort that out, what the problem was. We didn't know whether it was an orthopedic issue or whether it was his Parkinson's from rigidity or dystonia.
The pain that I'm describing in my back area was very intense, very severe. Couldn't get no relief at all.
I think that pain as a non-motor symptom is very disabling.
Couldn't even get out of bed sometimes because of the pain.
So pain and depression definitely correlate strongly with each other.
When I was hurting, I was sad. I was doing everything I could to keep positive and thinking that everything was gonna loosen up and I was gonna get back to work. I wanted to function for my wife and my son and my friends and myself. I wasn't ready to throwing the towel just yet.
If the pain is from Parkinson's disease, it often will get better when you give the patient appropriate medication to treat their symptoms.
Let's just get an idea of how bad the pain is. Can you give me a sense on the scale here, how much pain you're experiencing right now?
I'm having maybe about 2 to 4.
And so the goal of a neurologist taking care of a Parkinson's patient is really to help improve their on time so that they don't have these windows in their day where their symptoms are very severe and there won't be as much pain then as well.
We're really hoping that when we treat the Parkinson's symptoms with medications, with DBS or with Botox, that we're really relieving that pain syndrome so they can carry on their life.
Exercise is one of the most powerful forms of treatment that we have, not just for Parkinson's, for many other health conditions.
And we know that if patients do exercise and are moving their bodies more, that they will have less pain, actually have less progression of the disease as well.
In January, Dr. Glass increased my medication to 4 tablets every 3 hours. I was only getting like 7 minutes of actual movement, and then I would have to take another 4 tablets, but it had no relief of pain at all. I tried, I went to physical therapy where they prescribed for me a heating pad and a pillow to lie on to try to adjust my spine. I went to acupuncture. I tried yoga. couldn't get no relief at all.
When he had deep brain stimulation surgery about a year ago, the majority of his pain improved.
Well, right away I noticed with the DPS inserted in me that I had a free range of motion in my shoulders, and the pain still was there because it was with me for so long that I still felt the pain, but I didn't feel the tightness in my shoulders.
After he had DBS, the pain that he had in his mid-thoracic region, and there was also some pain, I think, in his low back and in his feet, improved dramatically. And so that told us that that pain was probably from rigidity or dystonia.
My pain level right now, on a scale from 1 to 10, between now and my past pain, it'll probably be 1.5 to 2, considering before I could have been a 10 or maybe even a 15.
And so we're managing him still with Parkinson medicines. We're offering him Botox. He still needs physical therapy, but he gets around really well. Miles has some dystonia, residual dystonia in his great toe, where it's really dorsiflexing up towards his head, and it's quite painful.
One of the side effects that I have, makes my toe stick up, pokes a hole right through my shoe, and these shoes are only 3 weeks old.
We're now down to offering Botox for him to try to focally make that muscle more relaxed, and so his toe will be more flat inside his shoes.
So we would usually place a needle about right in here, and that's about right where the muscle belly is that's controlling this muscle, and then we'd see the toe relax. We can't inject botulinum toxin throughout the whole body to improve pain. You ready to go? Okay, here we go. But if there's a specific body region that is impacted by overactive muscles or spasms or dystonia, then you can target those muscles that are overactive. All right, you did a great job. Nice job holding still, and you should start to feel better in about 4 to 5 days. You should start to make this toe relax and not continue to pop up like that, okay?
I don't think people need to live with their pain, but we, as providers, can't help you if you don't tell us that you're really suffering.
I would spend some time with somebody educating a person who has Parkinson's disease and pain that they're not alone, that there are many, many people who experience the same thing, and that they can do something about it.
I'm functioning, not perfect, but I'm functioning well, and I'm happy as a man to be functioning like this. My 13-year-old son benefits from it, my wife. I can buy a new pair of shoes. And I hope everybody that I touch.
We know that it's really important to actively engage in a social life and get those loved ones in your lives to stay around you, support you.
My pain tolerance is probably pretty high, but my wife coming home to me and my son coming home to me help ease a lot of that. And what makes me happy these days is keeping the house, being able to make decisions, paying my bills, being retired, even though I'd rather be at work. It's kind of nice being home. Making sure my son gets off to school. So I'm not scared anymore. I take a walk to the store, I walk my dog. I have conversations with people, try to enjoy life. A little bit slower, a little bit shakier, but everything's okay now.